गुड इवनिंग सुनैना, कैन यू इंट्रोड्यूस योर सेल्फ?
हेलो, एज यू नो माय नेम इज सुनैना। आई एम अ वॉलंटियर फॉर एसएमसी, जॉइंड रिसेंटली एंड अ बास्केटबॉल कोच, सो लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू वर्क विथ यू ऑल।
वेलकम टू द टीम सुनैना।
थैंक यू।
सो वी हैव द रिकॉर्डिंग ऑन and I'll start with introducing some of the members and then Vikas, and then we'll proceed to give the control to Vikas for the session. So today we have with us Mr. Ravi Kiran Tanali. He is the co-founder of SMC and he has worked at Olympics and US Open as head of operations and head of volunteers. We have Mr. Satyabrata Dash with us. He is the head of quality control. My name is Pratishtha Bhalla. I am a mind and memory coach and I'll be facilitating this session. Today we have with us Vikas Chauhan. Mr. Vikas Chauhan has represented Tamil Nadu and South India region in athletics, high jump, at junior and senior national level for 4 years. He held the record for under 17 high jump for 6 years and under 19 high jump for 9 years. For KV Sangathan. Currently, he is a director of an edutech startup called www.editor.org, which works with schools to improve the learning process of students. He has over 7 years of experience in training college students and faculty, trainers, working professionals on development of various skills. We welcome Vikas to this session, and over to you, Vikas, for this today's session.
Thank you so much, Pratishtha. I hope I'm audible and clear.
Yes, you are.
Great. So, okay, let me start.
But you are not visible. Will it be possible for you to switch on your camera?
Okay, I thought actually I have prepared a PPT to present whatever I wanted to share.
Okay, so we can, yeah. You can switch on the PPT as well.
I have started sharing. I hope it's visible.
Yeah, it's visible.
It's visible, Vikas.
Yeah, it's visible, Vikas.
All right, great. Thank you. So, good evening, everyone, and happy Friendship Day.
To you as well.
Nice. So I wanted to know my audience, what sport do you play or practice?
Prithvi, tennis.
Yeah,
because I'm a learner of tennis, and also I started coaching tennis as well.
When I'm displaying the PPT, only the PPT is visible on my screen. So unfortunately, I don't know who's speaking. So please, tell me your name and then answer. That would be very helpful.
Yeah, Vikas, this is Satyabrat. So I love to play tennis, and very recently I've started coaching. I started my stint as a coach with one student in one of the apartments in Hyderabad.
Cool.
Of course, it is referred by Mr. Davikiran.
Great. Others? Sachin, what about you?
Yeah, I play tennis and cycling is...
Okay, everyone plays tennis here. I guess I'm the odd one out.
We have Sunaina who plays basketball.
Yes, basketball, correct.
She's a very good tennis player.
Who else is there in audience? Oh, that's it. Okay. What about you, Pratishtha? Do you play anything?
Yeah, I play tennis and badminton, but I'm not a national level player or something. I play it because I like it.
Perfect. Yeah.
So we have Yashwant as well. Yashwant can tell us what he plays.
Hello.
Yes, yes, sir.
Sir, I also play tennis, sir, yoga, martial arts, etc.
Okay. All right. So this is a tennis cult, I guess. I'm an outcast. All right. Fine. Great. So everyone plays tennis, and Sunaina plays basketball. Sachin, apart from tennis, does cycling, and Pratishta, badminton.
And Yashwant, martial arts.
Yashwant, martial arts. Yashwant, okay, martial cool. Arts. Okay, I missed that. Cool. Nice. So I wanted to know why do you, you know, play or, yeah, no, nobody practices here, right? Maybe Yashwant does practice. I think everyone else is just, you know, playing and a couple of us coaching. So why did you take up this sport?
I took up because I love outdoor sports.
Okay.
One is it keeps you away from all your other pressures or whatever you have in life. You forget everything once you are on the court.
Mm-hmm.
You just play for the point or just think about the next ball and nothing else.
Mm-hmm.
One other thing is obviously to keep ourselves fit.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay, does tennis qualify as an outdoor sport? I'm sorry if it's a very lame question.
Yeah,
lawn tennis is outdoors.
Okay, all right.
And one other thing is the competitive spirit. You learn how you should be humble even after a victory, or how to cope up after a loss.
Okay. So, all right. So maybe cope up with highs and lows, or maybe lows and enjoy the highs.
Yep.
Okay.
And because tennis is very demanding game. It is the second or third most energetic game.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so it's very, you should always be on the high on your fitness, and mm-hmm. then you can think of reacting.
So it pushes you?
Exactly.
Yeah, if I'm not wrong, swimming is the first one and tennis is the second one for the highest burning calories.
Squash is also one of them. So that's why I'm a little bit confused. These three games are really very demanding in terms of physical fitness.
So I think we can go with Prithvi's answer because he would have Googled for sure right now as we speak.
Not right now, long back.
Okay, all right. Others, what are your reasons? Sunaina?
Yeah.
Why did you take up basketball?
I took up basketball because I saw it very energetic game on court mm-hmm. to play mm-hmm. and came into coaching. It's a big mm-hmm. reason for coming into a coaching. Mm-hmm. There where I found that as a coach in India, mm-hmm. especially, mm-hmm. coaches, they won't talk to their players.
Yeah.
So I thought as I become a coach and I'm training under 14 and under 18, under 11 students. So mm-hmm. when I talk to them, they mm-hmm. give their ideas, I give them ideas, they will cope up. So just to motivate them and mm-hmm. give a good competition. And in basketball, mm-hmm. as it is a team game where mm-hmm. they need to be very clear and know what are the rules and regulations. When I used to play basketball, I was like, mm-hmm. okay, sir told me this, okay, this is the rule. They never used to tell me the full rules and regulations. So I think when a player is playing on a court, they should know everything about the game, mm-hmm. what they are doing, how they are doing. So the reason why I took coaching
mm-hmm.
as my mm-hmm. profession and going on.
So you, by taking coaching, you want to contribute further?
Yeah, contribute further.
Okay, I'm a little tall. Sorry?
Yeah.
Yeah, I have really bad experience playing basketball. I'm like 6'1", and people think that yeah, I'm a basketball player whenever they see me. So, but then I'm pretty bad at it. I used to watch the game, but then never played. So once there was an opportunity for me to play after my workout. This was back in college, and I thought I'll play with the kids. It'll be easy to win also against them, score some points again. But you make one movement, and then there'll be like touch violation, yeah. something. So I was like, okay, that's it. Too many rules in basketball. I'm not going to play it ever. That's it. I gave up.
No, it's not like too many game. It's not touching game. Just you have to be far from the player. Your eyes focus on ball and your player. The team player you're playing with, just you have to know their movements, when they are moving, where they are moving, and pass them, making the strategies and all. It's a very interesting game once you go into it.
Yeah, once you get into it, yes, true. My first experience, I was trying to play rugby on a basketball court. So that's why maybe it didn't work out. I was trying to snatch and just run away from the ball.
Yeah, starting.
Yeah. So, anybody else? Did I miss out anyone? Anybody else who would want to contribute? Like, why did they take up the sport that they are currently playing?
Because we have a new participant, Harsha, just joined. Maybe you can just ask the question again.
Harsha. Okay. Hi, Harsha. So, what sport do you play or do you practice?
Harsha, you can unmute yourself and you can speak. Else you can write in the chat box.
Vikas, maybe you can go on.
Yeah. All right. No issues. Harsha, whenever you would want to, contribute, please feel free to. All right. So, okay. So, to sum up, summarize why all of each of us plays whatever the sport that we do. It's the love for the outdoors, stress buster and health. You know, the mental and physical health is what everyone talks about mostly. That in fact, almost is synonymous with sports, has been synonymous for sports for quite long. Now, things have started changing. Again, thanks to corporate, things have started changing. So, mostly people only talk about the mental benefits and health benefits of playing any sport. Could be indoor or outdoor, any sport, right? So what are the benefits? I'm not going to get into that because partially it has been already listed out in my previous question. So like I said, mostly people just associate sports with physical and mental well-being, but it's way beyond that. It contributes a lot to someone's life than just the physical and mental well-being. To help us understand that, most of us are in today's audience, most of you are at a professional level or have been at a professional level, so would be really easy for you to associate with whatever I'm going to talk about next or present next. For others, you would definitely have someone in your circle that you would have seen, practicing what I'm going to, discuss in the forthcoming slides. Let's see, what is the regime of an athlete? So athlete is not just, someone who is into athletics, but any sports person. Didn't want to, use sportsman because that rules out sportswoman, and sports person is not very common. So I chose athlete. So let's try to understand what is the regime of an athlete. Regardless of whatever level that the athlete is playing, maybe at state, school, or maybe international, something similar is the regime of every athlete, regardless of the level that he or she is playing. So it all starts with waking up early. You have to start your day pretty early because every athlete, professional athlete, has to work out twice a day, the morning session and evening, both equally important. So yeah, you begin with begin your day pretty early when compared to others, right? And then yeah, you go about your training. That happens every day, right? Regardless of what the climatic conditions are, regardless of what the political situation is or whatever it is, you have to train every day, right? Yes. So once you're done with your training, you would have some tasks to attend to. Either you could be attending school or college, you could be working, or professional athletes, they would have certain events to attend to, or they would have certain side hustle businesses that they would be running, taking care of, right? After which, regular attention or focus is on the diet. You have to consume really healthy food, right? And yeah, you have to stay away from these vices that might bring down your performance, to make sure that you're always staying in shape and able to deliver your best at your best, right? And yeah, one has to stay focused throughout, right? Whatever might be happening around you, right, you have to be staying focused on the game or whatever event you're participating in, right? As Prithvi rightly pointed out, that when he's playing tennis, he is only thinking about how to score the next point, or how is the, or what is going to be the opponent's next move, right? You're not thinking about anything else but just maybe living that moment, right? We set a lot of targets, right? This is an interesting image that I found while preparing the content for today's presentation. This is Michael Phelps' goals, which he chalked out for himself when he was just 8 years old. Okay, an 8-year-old kid has this clarity. In fact, his coach Bowman, yeah, his coach Bowman has said once that he's the most goal-oriented individual on earth, in this universe. Sorry, he said universe. Right. So setting targets is very important for every athlete, regardless of what sport you are part of. Right. You set targets for yourself, and then you plan, or you come up with a plan to achieve those targets. Right. And yeah, this is the result of what his planning and his grit and determination yielded. He's got more gold or more medals than some of the many of the countries out there, right? Yeah.
Just to add on to this point, I was watching Olympic at that time, and he has won 8 gold medals in swimming.
Yeah,
single
that was
guy
one.
in
Yeah,
one session, 8 gold medals. Yeah, please carry on with that.
So collectively, his total number of medal tallies is more than many nations, many countries, right? And if you take that particular Olympic event, even in that event, his tally was way more than many countries that were participating. Forget individual participation by athletes, right? So with achieving targets, you also have days, or maybe a long stretch of failures, when whatever you plan or whatever you seek to achieve doesn't happen, doesn't result what you expect to or what you want to, right? There cannot be any athlete any athlete out there who has not faced failure, or who has not come across a pretty long stretch of this feeling of not being able to accomplish anything or achieve something. And as Sunaina said, most of the times, coaches don't talk to their team, right? This is a very crucial period for the coach to identify. Many a times, the athlete doesn't come to the coach and say that, "Yeah, coach, I'm feeling a little low. It's not, happening. It's not working out. I don't know. I've lost my mojo," or something like that. The coach has to identify what is amiss, right? What is it that the kid or the athlete is not doing that he or she used to always? Okay, and then that is where I personally feel that coaches have to contribute a lot, right? And then yeah, another problem that again, no athlete can avoid is injuries. Right. So injuries are there, right? You would never know what could cause an injury. Right. You would be having a really impressive run, performing as expected. Right. Your body responding and you being at your best mentally. Right. But then boom comes this injury and then that's it, gone. Okay, you are away from the field. You cannot do anything about it. And that could be a little frustrating as well. Right. So this is to summarize, what an athlete or a sports person, right, usually experiences. So every day they wake up early. Right. And they go about training twice a day. They have to attend their school, college, work, or any other events that they have. Regularly ensure that healthy food is consumed and you stay away from things or vices that bring your performance down. Right. Thus, having that focus to be able to concentrate on the task at hand, it's really, really crucial. Right. Setting targets and achieving them. Experiencing failures, happens, and injuries, right? So what does this translate to? Okay, this is a summary of what is a usual life of a sportsman like, right? But what does this contribute? Okay, waking up early, it's not easy, right? Not many people are comfortable waking up early. There are people talking about waking up early as a really big thing. There are people talking about the 5 a.m. club, 4 a.m. club, and so on, right? But happens very seamlessly and very easily for these athletes, right? So each and every time when they are waking up, they are actually pushing themselves out of the comfort zone, right? Training every single day, right? I read this quote somewhere. Train even if it rains, because your skin is waterproof. This is what everyone believes. You don't see any event getting cancelled because of rain, unless it affects the infra required for the game, right? You don't find athletes stopping or postponing their training just because of some change in weather or anything, right? Come what may, training has to happen twice a day. During this COVID period, before the football season resumed, there were so many videos of how the football players were keeping themselves fit and sane, mentally stable, right? There were so many videos out there, right? So come what may, they have to stay fit. Training has to happen, right? That is talking about, or that is building consistency in a person, right? Now, you have to attend school, college, work, or something, right? You train in the morning, you train in the evening. What do you do rest of the day? Right? And you have to be pretty good at that. Right? You cannot be sleeping the whole day. You cannot be just playing games. Of course, that is what is shown, that football players are mostly playing FIFA whenever they're free, but they don't play that the whole day, right? They are doing something else. So that requires other skills, right? Not just what you have or what you need to be a good sports person. Right, so that brings in versatility in you. Right, healthy food. Yes, everyone knows what are the benefits. Right, but is it really, or is that motivation good enough to consume healthy food? Wild vegetables don't taste that good, right? Yes, there is a lot of dedication that is required to ensure that you consume healthy food.
A lot.
Right. And then your lifestyle cannot be like everyone else's, right? Right. Just because others, enjoy or indulge in, certain activities, you cannot, because you have to perform, right? You have certain goals which are waiting for you to be achieved. There is a lot of sacrifice that goes in to avoid getting indulged in these vices that might bring down your performance. Okay, focus. Yeah, it directly translates to focus itself, right? You have to have people have been talking about multitasking being such a good skill, right, at corporate. But now people have understood that no, multitasking is not good. Right? You have to be focused. You could be working on multiple tasks. You could be owning multiple responsibilities, departments, or whatever it is. Okay. But then when you're working on something, you have to be completely focused on that. Okay. And multitasking definitely doesn't help you with that. Okay. So that focus, I would like to talk about Rahul Dravid here. He was asked, right, how is he able to, you know, stay focused for so long, right? Test, I'm talking about, you know, the test cricket, right? Not the current version of cricket. So, which goes for like 5 days, and, you know, there are days when a batsman would be, you know, on, at the crease for more than a day, right? So, how is he able to maintain that kind of a focus and attention? He said it's just about, you know, turning on and off your focus. So when the bowler is not bowling really well, or the deliveries are not that great, I turn off my focus. And then when the ball coming at me are like really, really good, then I, you know, turn the focus on. Okay, so to be able to focus completely at the task, it's a very, very, you know, valuable skill. Right? You set and achieve targets, right? That is how you plan. Right, you want at a corporate level or something, right? You want to achieve something, so first you set a target, right? And then you go about building the plan on how are you going to do that. Okay, so Michael Phelps' plan or goal, he had said that he wants to become an Olympic swimmer, and then he wants to you know, qualify at junior level. And what has to be done to achieve that? He had mentioned, he had written the timing that he has to achieve. Right, and then what should you do to go about achieving that time? Right, that brings out your or that is your workout, right? And this is exactly what the sales team does in any company. Right? They set a target for themselves, like this is the revenue that they are going to generate. Now, how are they going to generate this revenue? How much is going to come from existing clients? How much are they required to bring in from new clients? And then they chalk out the plan for the year, for the financial year, right? Failure, a very, according to me, you know, this is the most important, you know, pointer in this list. Okay. It is very important for every player, every athlete to face failure. Right? That is what is true test of your character, right? I'm going to touch upon a really sensitive topic here, okay, and that is about the student suicides, right? There are a lot of you know, suicides being committed by students almost every other day, right? And that is majorly because, personal opinion, that is majorly because, you know, they don't know how to cope up with the failure, right? I don't say that athletes have not, sports persons have not committed suicide, right? They also have, okay, but that is not the example that has to be considered for this, right? They are few in number, very few in number. Okay, so in general, every sportsman has faced, or every athlete has faced failure, some part of the other during the journey of, or during the sports journey, right? That resilience that comes with getting back up every single time that you fall is, again, you know, building your character, right? Injuries, you would not know, right, what might cause an injury. There could be a slight bump in the field and that's it. You land your foot there and that's it. It twists your ankle, right? On that particular day, you would not have consumed enough liquid and that's it. You or maybe you were severely dehydrated than anticipated, and that's it, you get a cramp, right? So you try to control as much as you can, but then you cannot have complete control over, and that's what life is all about, right? Expecting the unexpected, right? Being prepared for unexpected. So every time a sportsman gets, a sportsperson gets injured, right, that is some uncertainty that he or she gets exposed to. Right? And this is what everyone is talking about right now. What is the impact that is going to happen on athletes because of postponement of the Olympics? They were supposed to happen, right? And you have your peak season, you have your off season, that is all planned based on which event you're going to participate. Right? So someone who wanted to participate in the Olympics would have started the off season, right, at least 12 months back, right? And then you start building upon that, your speed season, your competitive season, your mid season, and so on, right? And all of that has gone waste. Okay, so nobody had any control over it. So then what next? There is a lot of talks about, it also comes in as an advantage for certain athletes. For example, Neeraj Chopra, that's our next bet in athletics, right? Javelin thrower. He's currently ranked number 4. Okay. Now, the good news for him is that he is in his early 20s, whereas the top 3 are in the late 20s or already in the early 30s. Right. So, for certain people, yes, it has come out as a boom. Majorly, people have been affected. So, how do you, tackle these uncertainties? Right, and this is what builds your character. Okay, so unmindful of what as an athlete or was what as a sports person you have been doing every single day has been silently shaping up this character of yours. Okay, if you talk to a lot of if you talk to any athlete or any sports person who has played at a competitive level would agree to this part, that many times they would be appreciated for having done something which they thought was very, very simple, and they would not know why are they being appreciated. Okay, because it's pretty common, pretty normal for them. But what they don't realize is that it is common and normal for them because they have been doing something each and every single day to have built that character. Right, yes. Someone gets into sales, right? Sales people keep talking. I have recently started this ed tech company, and sales is what I want to take up as one prime responsibility. I have started watching a lot of videos on sales, so most of my examples are going to be on sales. So please bear with that. So people keep talking about sales being a very tricky thing, and unfortunately in India, very, very shameful act, because what we think about. What comes first in our mind when we talk about sales is those salesmen, who are walking on streets selling you encyclopedia, right? But that is not what it is. It's way more than that, right? So people think that, sales is not for everyone. Not everyone can do sales, so and so forth. It's only for the extroverts, who can go about talking to people, who are okay in, just like that, going and approaching a stranger and are able to build a conversation. Okay. But actually, deep down, sales is just two simple things. Okay. Planning or setting a target for yourself, right? And a discipline of following it every single day. Okay. Follow-ups. Follow-ups is what, fetches you more business than anything else. Okay. Your client says that, okay, I'm not free today, call me after a week. Exactly after a week, the client should get your call or should get some reminder from you. Okay. Now, that kind of a discipline, others have to start working on it, have to build it, have to do it. But take a sports person and then it comes innately to that person, to the athlete, right? And then that athlete gets appreciated, but he or she is not able to understand why is this such a big deal. That is only because he or she has been doing something every single day.
In the day-to-day, right? Life.
In the day-to-day life, exactly. Right? So, sports is not just about, getting that health or the fitness or, that mental health. Right? It's way more than that. Personally, I had, after I had quit, sports, I was not doing anything, to stay fit. And then after the break of like almost 10 years, I thought, okay, let me start doing something. And then I started, you know, hitting gym and then some running on the roads, all of that. And then one day I was sitting and introspecting, like, why did I resume or why did I stop? Okay, the resumption was because I realized that I had started, you know, quitting things very easily. Right, and then I realized that that has started happening ever since I quit, you know, sports. Because I was like, okay, I was into high jump. Now you cannot go into high jump. You have to have a lot of, you know, infra support to do high jump. But then I need not do high jump to practice this skill that I had built or this character that I had built. Right? And I could relate to, right? When I resumed working out, I could see that, yes, I was able to push myself little more, little longer. Okay. And with that came in a lot of confidence. I'm pretty sure all of us today would have, you know, such stories. Would be great if, you know, you guys can. I had actually not planned to ask this question, but then, you know, given the audience that we have today and, you know, small number, I think we can definitely have this interaction. It would be great if, you know, you can share such, you know, anecdotes or experiences. Anyone?
Yeah, hi, Prithvi here. Coming to that topic, I started tennis in my schooling, and as you know, once you're into your 10th, everyone is behind you for your board exams, then your intermediate, career, etc. So in a similar way, I had to stop my tennis career in my 10th class. Then about for 2 years intermediate and 4 years BTEC, I had no opportunity. Then I was like, I am done with it. I lost my passion, etc. Then somewhere in my MBA, again, I had a lot of free time. Then I spoke to myself. I started thinking, what can I do? Then I started taking up some home tuitions and I started earning some money and bought my own racket, started collecting money for my coaching fee, etc. And I'm back to tennis. And it's been 7 years I'm back onto court right now. So, yes, the same dedication we show in other things, once you do that, like even at work, once you are down, you're not able to do something, then you'll speak to yourself thinking, why not? You can rise again after every failure. So definitely sport has been my best companion in life. So whenever any problem, as Vikas said, you can find solutions in a similar way what you do on the court. Not the exact ways, but the similar ways. Thanks.
Thanks, Prithvi. Anybody else? Anyone who would want to share something?
Yes, I have a good experience playing sports.
Mm-hmm.
I started playing sport in my intermediate. So from the college, I met my coach Naeem sir, Naeemuddin, basketball coach. Once when I got selected, when I start practicing and all, when I got selected for college level, so there we were having a state selection for the first time. Then I got easily into it. So then it was like I was young at that time, and it was like I got very easily into state level. And I was having that, it's very easy to do and all. When I went for my first state level tournament, then I saw players playing and all. The senior most team was there. We got a chance playing against them in semifinals. That moment, we lost with 3 or 4 points. I don't remember. That was the moment where I was like, no, I need to start doing more practice and all. Before that, I stopped going to the practice, like reduced everything and all. Then from that moment, I started and came up with all training and all, asking my coach what to do, what not to do, and he was very helpful. So as I took basketball as my profession, but I should appreciate my physical education teacher. She made me play every sports, including yoga, judo, handball, volleyball, and many other sports, all ball sports, including softball. So she was like, if you play every sport, you will get the knowledge of everything you can open. You can improve your own profession sports by playing other sports. Where you see some of them, they will stop basketball ball players playing indoor games like table tennis on all. They will be like, don't play and all. But here I got a good opportunity of playing indoor and outdoor games. So it was very good. And I continued playing for my college for 5 years, then played state levels and national levels, including universities and all. So it was a very good experience going through and being a coach now. That's all from my side.
Nice. Thank you, Sunaina. Inviting others to share their similar experiences.
I guess in sports you will be having many experience and very excitement inside to tell it out.
Yeah, I mean every sportsman, you know, has really really interesting anecdotes to share.
Yeah. Hi, this is Nadeem here.
Hi, Nadeem.
Hello.
Yeah. It was a nice session. Hello. Hello.
Yes, you're audible. Please go ahead.
We can hear you.
Yeah. So really, fitness, actually, I was a former hockey player and now I'm into fitness. So the more I do fitness and get the discipline in my life, I started feeling young. I started feeling very energetic and the whole, whatever business I'm doing is becoming successful. So fitness is very, very important and the mindset is very, very important to continue throughout your life. So your session was good. Thanks.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay. Anybody else who would want to add, share, contribute?
As on failure we spoke, we living in this generation, we always talk about success. Mm-hmm. No one talks about failure. So if you are a coach, if you are a parent, anything, if you are with someone or your friend circle, anywhere, it's very important to talk about failure and success. And talking about success, you can keep it at second, but talking about failure, you can keep it first, if you all agree.
Totally.
Which I have experienced till now.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a good point. Failure is also part of the life.
Yes. Okay, so we have plans. We have plans for the success. Okay, I got success. Now next will be this. But we don't have any plans for failures. Okay, I failed. What to do next? The students and anyone, they get panic. So it will be better if we talk about failure more and success less. As success, if we know, we climbed up. Now we have to go in other level. Okay, my level one is done. Now it's level two.
For a sportsman, every day it's a failure and success because he loses some matches, he wins some matches. So the mindset and psychology built up like that. But people who is only into theoretical things, like, you know, who comes state first or top in education, they don't have that kind of mindset. So that's where they try to suicide, they try to, do something. For a sportsman, it is fail and success is both the same. You don't need to plan for failure. You always have to dream and visualize for success. Okay, if failure comes, okay, just like you take a shower, it's end. What is the next? You have to start thinking. So in life, whether it's in business or in sports, anywhere, you give all your best to do something. So you don't worry about the results, whether it's a positive or negative. So when you think about the results, then only the whole stress will come. So when you don't have any worry about the result, you're just giving your 100%. You're competing yourself. You wanted to be better than before. Then what will happen is you don't worry whether whatever the results comes. And when you give 100%, obviously result will be good. Even if the result is bad, your focus is what is the next task. You quickly jump into the next task. That's how you know I was doing throughout my life. Pratibha, you can give some points in this.
Absolutely, sir. Yes, Naveen sir, that is actually you are telling something from experience, and it is really important that you don't take anything too seriously. It is when you take failures too seriously or success too seriously, then you actually fail. So if you don't succeed in a match, just move on to the next match.
Yeah. No, not only the match. If you develop that kind of psychology, whether it's in the job, whether it's in the business, whether it's in the relationship, yeah, whether it's in anything in life, so you have to give your best for everything. So it happens, happen, doesn't happen, doesn't happen, what next? You don't need to plan to fail. So whatever you plan, it will happen.
So yeah, you just need I think you just need to be ready that yes, failures are going to come. So after like 10 rejections, 10, I'm saying a lower number, after 100 rejections, you get 10 yes. So be ready for those 100 rejections in your mind that, okay, every rejection, now I'm closer to my goal, one step closer to my goal. So that is how you pass this negative phase. Like when you are feeling rejected, just think it as a positive thing. Now I have faced one rejection, now I am one step closer to my yes.
And it is always the first failure that is difficult, okay, to bounce back, because you don't know, you're clueless about what to do next, right? So what one must do immediately after experiencing any failure is just get back up. Okay, I went for a competition, I did not perform as I expected.
Nana, for this thoughts of yours, it was really useful for all of us.
Thanks, Sumana. Thanks.
Well, my viewpoint is that actually, when you are in learning mode, your mind is in learning mode. When the failure comes, so yes, some sort of rejection comes to us. But after that, we analyze actually what is the lesson learned from that. So what processes went wrong? So that comes when your mind is in learning mode. So if the mind is conditioned to only success, so it is sometimes very difficult to accept the failure. But if it is in learning mode, so when the failure comes, out of that state of mind, then we analyze, we dissect the problem, which processes went wrong, and what needs to be, what requires rectifications. All these processes will ensue subsequently. So then my question to Sunaina is that, being a coach,
yes,
the students sometimes they fail. Sometimes they don't succeed in the matches. So what exactly you do as a coach?
As a coach, I cheer up them. I tell them there is nothing about to be sad or get depressed, because this was just a match and we are having one more match coming up. Get ready for it and let's practice more. And I tell them what wrong we did in the match, that we didn't achieve the total score and all. So we will have a good decision among student players and coach. They will come up with different ideas and all, and we start going happily. So this question, what I said, as adults, we know we keep our mindset focused. Yes, we will be like, yeah, failure. Okay, we will cope up. But in youth, when children are playing, they don't know to keep their mindset where, what to do, because they are in a learning stage. So we as a mentors or adults, we should talk to them about failures. We should tell them that fail, nothing will happen if you fail. You can get up and you can go and you can do better. Maybe more better is coming for you. It's just a match. Let's try one more time. So this is what I meant about planning about failures and talking about failures. If we live in a family where we see parents, they tell them they will be talking about getting first, being on top. So children, they won't talk to their parents. They won't talk to their parents about that. They talk to their friends and all. So if you are a friend, if you are a mentor, if you are anywhere, and just you can talk about a failure. Oh, you're writing an exam, it's okay. If you pass, that's fine. If you fail, don't worry. You can learn, prepare it better, and give it again. That's it. That just a few words and over.
Absolutely. Yes, Vikas, what are your thoughts on this?
Yeah, I was about to... See, we start talking about failure or success after, you know, the event concludes, right? Actual preparation should happen, you know, to make the kids understand that it's a journey, and that journey or the process has to be enjoyed. For yeah. example, how I was coached, not by my coach, but my senior, he used to tell me that set a target for every competition. Okay, and the target should not yes. be the medal. Don't set gold, bronze, or silver, right? Set a target. Okay. That. So I was in high jump, so we would be like, okay, 1.87, 1.93, 198, 201. Okay, depending on the level of competition and the age group that you're part of, set a target accordingly. Okay. And that helped me. Okay, that helped me. And I was, when, you know, I participated at, you know, some senior university level and senior level, I came across a lot of other athletes who were practicing the same. Okay, so when casually we, you know, talk and interact with them, we ask, so what is your plan about this meet or what are you going to do? Most of them, you know, they had a number in mind. Like, I want to achieve this. My jump should be this much. Okay. I should be able to clock this many minutes and seconds, maybe these many seconds. Right. This is the distance that I should be able to throw. That is what most of these athletes would talk about. So they were there not to, you know, win medals or anything. They were there to, you know, accomplish a feat which was measurable in terms of numbers. Okay.
Perfect.
One advantage is that, you know, even if you know, you don't get gold medal or anything, you had set a target of 2.08 meters, you jumped 2.08. Great. Okay. Another advantage is that if you are able to, you know, jump 2.08, if you have the capability of jumping 2.08, but in you jump just 2.01 and you're able to win the gold, and that's it, you would stop, right? But because you have set a target of 2.08, you will go further, right? You would want to continue jumping even after 2.01, right? Because that is the target that you have set, and that is how records get created.
Absolutely.
Okay, so when we start coaching kids, you know, if I may, this is a suggestion that I would want to give you, that set targets about not the winning or losing or anything associated with that, but, you know, performance. Measure the performance.
Yeah,
that is
absolutely.
What sports is all about.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Yeah. So,
in tennis, they say that high percentage tennis, at least 55%, or at least you should be ahead of 2-3, by 2-3 percentage of your opponent. You may commit errors, but at least you should be ahead of him, the opponent, by 5% or 6%. So they call it as high percentage tennis. So you should be just slightly better off so that you can just, I mean, go to the next level. It's not that you always doing right. So there is a possibility that you might have unforced errors, you might have you might go strategically wrong. But ultimately, you have to come back and you have to ensure that you just be ahead of him by 2% or 3%. So that you'll be at the next level. So So it's like setting up the target, as you said, setting up the target and pursuing that target in a very sincere way, and not just achieving the medal. And probably these are the process-centric approach might help the person not to be dejected when the failure comes in.
And this just reminded me of another experience. So we were in Warangal. It was 2003 or 2002. I'm not able to recollect the year exactly. So it was a South region meet. So I was representing Tamil Nadu there, and there were athletes from four states: Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Kerala, and Andhra. During our event, there was a guy who was from Karnataka, and he was giving suggestions to a guy from my team. Like, you know, you should do this. Maybe you should start your run up a little late. Okay. And do this, and you'll be able to jump well. Right. So he was helping his competitor. Right. That is the true spirit of sportsmanship, right? But we don't advocate that anymore. We are only talking about medals. We are only talking about winning and losing, right? Nobody's talking about enjoying the process, which further puts pressure on the kids, or maybe later on, you know, when they become professional athletes, right? That nobody is talking about enjoying the whole process of improving yourself. Right. And I was talking about how sports helps you build character, but that should not be the objective why anyone should take up sports. Right. Sports should be taken for the heck of it, right? Not because it helps you build a competitive character, not because it helps you garner skills which would translate to success at business, corporate, or whatever your vocation is, right? That should not be the objective, and this I feel should be advocated every now and then, and more right when compared to winning medals.
Absolutely.
So, in fact, this was the concluding part of my presentation. My next two slides would have spoken about the fact that yes, sports does help you build character, but that is not why one should be taking up sports. You know, take up sports to enjoy the whole process and for the heck of it.
Absolutely. And with our current education policy, we are hoping that sports will also become a mandatory subject. So that will be actually a welcome change, and we'll see more people playing sports actually.
That would be great if it happens, because my chemistry ma'am always took our games period.
Yeah, and in the games period, some children also used. I remember the girls would take a corner and just sit and not play, and I was always wondering when they would start playing. So I always get reminded of this memory of my childhood that I wanted to play but didn't had like girls wanted to chit chat. So I hope that thing can be stopped now with the current all of them. Because I think games should be a part of all of our life, because if we see life also, we get a lot of in a lot of places we get stuck, but if we have that player mentality, we will be able to get it through. Like, once we get the player mentality, the athlete's mentality of taking challenges, and all the information that nice information that you have shared with us today, once people are able to implement it is they are certainly going to excel in life as well. So with that, I would also like to introduce to all the participants here that SMC has come up with a special program for upcoming coaches, which is actually trying to change this entire scenario, the game that has been there, or because the coaches till date, they are a very big problem is many coaches are not trained at that level of competence, especially when we compare to American countries or Western countries. Like you gave the example of Michael Phelps. So the level of training that he got were because he was with really trained coaches. So we are trying to bring that thing to India as well. And I would like to introduce to you about with this game, with this certification program that we have come up with. So with your permission, if I have your permission, can I show a presentation, a small presentation for the upcoming certification program? Just write a yes or say a yes and I'll open the presentation.
Yes.
If I have your permission.
Yes, you can go ahead.
Okay, thank you so much. Anybody else interested? Just one yes. Okay, so Ravi yes. sir is putting his hand up, so I'll start sharing the presentation. Just let me know if my screen is visible. My presentation is visible.
Yes, it is visible.
Is it visible?
Yes.
Hello.
Yes, it is visible.
Yeah, so as I said that for the future of sports and coaching, to bring that level of coaching to India, SNC has come up with some programs. But one question that I need to ask before is, do you think all good players can be good coaches? Do you think you need...
No.
Right, because when you are playing, you are at a different level of a game, but a coach needs to have a different approach than a player. So,
and a different mindset.
Absolutely. Do you feel a coach plays a significant role in the life of athletes?
Yes.
Yeah, so one yes. Anybody else with a yes? Please unmute and say yes.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm getting some yes. So this is a resource that 90% of the youth sports coaches are untrained. They are not trained to that level. So they are just doing what they think can benefit the their coachee, but they are not trained for it. And during these times, we certainly need to do things differently. See, the coaches were not even prepared because suddenly the COVID came and everybody was forced to work online. Many people were not prepared for it. Along with that, the time has actually changed. The thing that used to work 20 years back no longer works. So we need to shift the way we are coaching to another level. We need to get the skills. So of the coaches as well as the coachee to another level. And we need to know that when people have skills, then they are not scared. So you might have noticed that a lot of athletes play really well, but when it comes to the real match, they do get scared. When it comes to uncertainty, a lot of coaches also did get scared that how will I go online? But if they had this right skill, they would not have been scared. So in our effort to contribute to the future of sports, SMC has come up with this program, which is CSCP, Certified Sports Coach Program. It is a 3-month intensive program that we will be working with you. The classes will be, it will be having online live classes. You will be getting a lot of information on how exactly the sports coach needs to work, how he needs to differentiate himself from other coaches. It will be completely online and it will have complete coaching concepts along with references to, which means they will be in line with ITF and Olympics. So what will you learn in this coaching program? You will understand the core of coaching. You will understand the mindset of a coach. Just now, Sunaina mentioned that mindset is very important. And the mindset of a coach is one of the most important parts because that will determine how his coaches are playing. So, and also during the session today, we noticed that there is a lack of communication that happens between the coach and the coachee. Sunaina, I think, mentioned it, that the players are not able to talk to their coach. So in this yes. program, we will be teaching advanced communication skills, which will not be just how what you are speaking, but and build a real rapport with all your coaches. Because every athlete is different in some way. And to for the coach, it is important that they communicate with the athlete in a way he understands or she understands. So for that, he needs not only communication skills, he needs advanced communication skills, how to build rapport, what kind of language to be used, and then how to understand what the athlete is actually thinking. So it will be covered in this course. Along with that, we will be covering problem solving skills, continuous improvement. We will be also taking advanced skills like visualization, imagery. Imagery is a very important and a core part of every athlete's life, that how, what kind of imagination, what kind of visualization that athlete needs to do before the match. Today, Nadeem sir mentioned that he used to visualize his success. One needs to visualize their success before the match. So we will be talking on those advanced concepts as well. So along with that, so just tell me till now, do you like what will be taught in this program? How many of you like what will be taught in this program till now? There is lot more, but
everything.
Okay, so I'm getting answers from Sunena and anyone else. You just need yes or no. Yes, you like what has been covered till now?
Yes, that sounds interesting.
Yeah, so we move to the next. We'll be giving a lot of bonuses. The first bonus is exclusive webinars by industry experts. Sports, just like today we had an expert with us, Vikash, who shared real gems of knowledge. So for the 3 months period, there will be exclusive webinars for the participants, which is worth 24,000. Then we will be having special session by former Indian hockey player Mr. Nadeem, who is present today also, and he really shared his own experience, and this is what makes the difference. Somebody who has been there, who has done that, and when he shares his knowledge, it is actually something you can just trust. You don't have to think twice that yes, this person has done it. So you will be able to model him completely. So a special session will be given by him, which is worth 10,000. Then I'm a mind and memory coach, and I counsel people a lot regarding their mental issues, what exactly their issue is, what is stopping them from being successful, or if they had faced some setbacks, how it is impacting them and how they can get out of it. So I will be giving a special 30-minute counseling session to accelerate your journey, especially. Also, I have some courses on my website. So I will be given a 1 hour pre-recorded session on goal smashing mindset, because mindset is extremely important. Once you have the right mindset, no goal is unachievable. We have seen people who didn't have the best circumstances, external circumstances, still they succeeded because of this one thing. So I will be providing access to this course, which is worth $9.99. Also, we will be giving access to a closed Facebook group. So you will be having an opportunity to network with people, like-minded people. So people who think just like you, who have faced those problems. So you will have a networking opportunity. Also, some tasks will be given to you, which you need to do on the Facebook group. So that will make you visible in front of other friends. So you will get the opportunities where you will network with them. And also, once you start networking, you start getting opportunities as well. So you will be able to get those kind of opportunities. So till now, the bonus is of 37999. Tell me, say a yes if you like this. Do you like these bonuses till now?
Yes, I
do. Yeah, so we have more participants. Yeah, I'm getting answers. Yes, yes. So now the CSCP certification, it is a triple certification, means you get 3 different certificates when you complete this course. And this entire course, along without the bonuses, this complete course itself has a value of 34999. because it is an intensive course. We are going to teach advanced level skills in here. So the total value that we are going to provide is of 72,998, and that is immense value. So just write in a chat box value if you like this amount of value that is being given to you. Write B. If you think that this is of valuable, just write B. So friends, this course is not of 72,998 for now, because you have given us so much time, and we are trying to spread this knowledge across India. We are trying to make this course available to all the people who actually want to succeed as a coach. We are just giving it at a very special price, which is 3,999. So you are getting material worth of 72,998 just for 3,999. If you see the value, but the thing is, this price is only available for a very limited time. So if anyone wants to register, they need to register today itself. So if you register today itself, you will get it at 3,999 with all the bonuses. Okay, so if you need to register yourself, you need to contact Ravi sir or Satya sir, or you can contact Sachin, and they will be taking you to the process of how you can get yourself registered for the course. The course will start from 15th August. And I did not mention the classes. The classes, the classes will be conducted by me, by Satya sir, who has a lot of experience in quality management. Then Ravi sir, who has over 20 years of knowledge in this business, and Nadeem sir. Along with that, we will be having Dr. Bhaktiar Chaudhary. We will try to get him as well. So you need to see this link that has been shared by Ravi sir, and you have to register today itself if you would like to get it at this price. Because this is an introductory batch, this is the price of the course. But the value that you are going to get is going to be immense. You can already see that the webinars that we are providing, these are so valuable, and they have the best of people from the industry. Okay, so this was my small thing that I wanted to share with all. And Vikash, it was a really, really amazing session that you had taken for us. And I really resonated with the thing when you said that we need to have goals. And that made me smile also, because in this course, we are going to share exactly how the students need to create, the coaches need to create goals, as well as create outcomes, means one step beyond goals. Like, if you create a goal, why do you need that goal? So creating outcomes. So we will be teaching that at an advanced level as well.
Thank you so much. Well, the pressure was all mine. And then I'm really happy that, SMC has taken such an initiative. Because I struggled, to find a good coach. My coach, I'm pretty sure even now, if I go to the stadium on a Monday, the kids will be, just doing a 100 meters fast run and a 50 meters jog. Even now, this is going to be the workout that I'm going to see that, because they're not trained, they're not, well educated in this area, to be able to nurture talent, how it should happen. I'm really happy, and, all the best to you guys, to help us get, really good coaches, and really they can get us at the level in the international sports arena that we want us to be.
Thank you so much, Vikash. Yes, this is the effort that we are trying to put in through with SNC. Like, we are trying to create this course, which is actually going to be beneficial for the coaches, and have those ingredients which are used by the international coaches, like sports psychology, how to handle injury. These things are completely ignored. Being ignored at a very good level when it comes to Indian coaching arena. So So yes, we are working on improving that. And thank you so much for appreciating. I hope a lot of people become part of this initiative. Ravi sir, would you like to say anything?
Yeah, because I appreciate your presentation. It was very informative and very knowledgeable. And I was also able to gain a lot of knowledge from your presentation. Thank you so much for being on our webinar, and then hope to see you soon again. And thank you, volunteers. Thank you, Prithvi. Thank you, Sunaina. Thank you, Sachin. And thank you, Satya and Pratishta. And thanks, everyone, for being here.
Thank you to all the volunteers from my side as well.
Thank you all.
Thank you everyone.
Thank you to the participants as well for their valuable time.